Hello friends, this is Vasant Nayak from Vastech channel. Please subscribe to our channel. We will update latest information for you. Thank you.
So welcome back students. In the last class, last video, you have seen RDT 3.0 protocol. So RDT 3.0 protocol is a category of stop and wait protocol. So we saw the disadvantage of that one. That is, it will not make use of the channel bandwidth properly. Utilization of channel bandwidth is not proper. So what we did, what was the alternative for that one? The alternative for that one is pipeline protocol. In the pipeline protocol, we will send packets without expecting acknowledgement immediately. As soon as the acknowledgement comes, you will decide, sender will decide the packet has to be resent or not. So we'll see now the pipeline protocols. The category of pipeline protocol is, one is go back and N, other one is selective repeat. Go back and N means sender can have up to N unacked packets in the pipeline. So in the pipeline protocols, there are two categories, go back and N and selective repeat. So here go back and N means, suppose the sender receives, if doesn't receive acknowledgement, then it will send all lots of packet, that is N unacked packets, it will resend. And please remember, receiver will only send a cumulative acknowledgement. It is not necessary for the receiver to send acknowledgement for the each packet. And third point you have to remember, receiver if gets out of order packet, it will just refuse it, or it will drop that packet into the bin. This is why, because I will explain you this one in the later session. And sender has the time for the oldest unacked packet. When the timer expires, sender will retransmit the packet. All these important points from the go back and N, we will see this one. So here you see, this is actually called as sliding window protocol. The other name for this one is a sliding window protocol. In this one, you can see this color. This color indicates already acknowledged, the packet is sent and already acknowledged. This one is yellow color, it indicates the packet is sent and our sender is waiting for the acknowledgement. And here the sequence number is ready for the next set of packets. So the packet sent and unacknowledged, and till here the sequence number, this set of sequences are called as window size. So let me repeat, window size is the range of permissible sequence numbers for transmitted but not yet acknowledged packets, can be viewed as a window of size N. So in this, we are using four variables here. One is send underscore base, which indicates the oldest unacknowledged packet. And next sequence number, which indicates the smallest sequence number, can be used for the next packet being sent. So if you are using, then now the question comes, what is the range of sequence number? If you are using k bit, then 2 raised to power k is the sequence number. That is 0 to 2 raised to power k minus 1 is the sequence number. In the earlier protocol, stop and wait protocol, it was 1 bit protocol, only 0 and 1 we used. But here it is not like that. Here it is there is a range for the range of sequence number we are using, that is 0 to 2 raised to power k minus 1. 2 raised to power k minus 1 is the sequence number in go back and go back n. So now how this works, all these things we have to see. Please remember, sender will use, receiver will use acknowledgement, community acknowledgement. And sender will use the timer for the oldest packet. And if the timeout occurs, that means if it doesn't receive, for example, in this diagram, this is the oldest packet. If it doesn't receive and it has already sent this packet, these many packets, and next packet it has to send is this one. And if the timer expires for this packet, already timer is started, and if the timer expires, then it will send, resend all these packets. That's why it is the name, go back and send all unacknowledged packet. So we'll see the FSM of this one, go back and send. It is called as extended FSM because we are using certain variable, and based on the variable, we use some statement like if else, etc. That's why it is called as extended FSM. So here you can see here, first we will take base is 1 and the next sequence number is 1, something like that. And it is waiting for the packet. As soon as the packet comes, it will check. If the next sequence number is less than base plus n. So let me take, this is base b. And this is the next sequence number. Next sequence number, what we are going to use. And till here, this is the window size. This is window size, n. So as soon as the data comes, it will check whether the next sequence number falls under this one, base plus n. Base plus n, then only it will create the packet. For example, the sequence number is somewhere here. That means it has sent all the in this window, it has sent all the packet, but it is unacknowledged. From year to year, it had sent the packet, and all the packets are not unacknowledged, and timer is also not timeout. That time, data comes from the upper layer. There is no space, there is no sequence number to create the packet. That time it will refuse the data. See here, refuse the data. Otherwise, it will create the packet by using next sequence number data checksum. And it will update base is equal to, that is the one condition. If base is equal to next sequence number, start the timer. For example, you see, till here all the packets are acknowledged. This is the next sequence number now. And this itself base. Then it will start the timer. It will start the timer. For example, we'll go back to our previous window, and we'll go back to the previous window. So you just think like in this scenario, it has sent all the packets. Now this is the next sequence number, and this is the window. This is the next sequence number, and it is starting from here, and this is the base itself. This is the next sequence number. Then what it will do when it sends the next sequence number, it will start the timer. and it will consider that the first or base. It will consider that it as the base. So that is the case here. Second one is, suppose here this is the range, this is the base, and it has sent next sequence number to be this one. This is the next sequence number, and so many unacknowledged packets are there, and timeout occurs. Then once again, what it will do? It will send base, base plus 1, base plus 2 till here. It will send and it will start the timer. Got it? Now, it has received the acknowledgement. It has received the acknowledgement. Then what it will do? Let me use different color here. For example, as soon as it receives the acknowledgement with particular sequence number, it will equate that to base. Now base is equal to nothing but acknowledgement number what it has received. For example, it received the acknowledgement for this one. Acknowledgement is cumulative. That means for somewhere this packet it has received the acknowledgement. Now it will make this is base. That means all the packets from year to year is received properly by the receiver. That is the meaning. Now, if the base is equal to next sequence number, stop the timer, else they start the timer once again. If the base is equal to the next sequence number, for example, if this is the base, then stop the timer or else start the timer. And if it receives a packet and it is corrupted, then it will, if receives the packet and if it is corrupted, it will wait for the timeout. It will wait for the timeout because this is the property of the GBN. As soon as the timeout occurs, it will resend all the packets, all the unacknowledged packets. That is the property of the this one. What is this one? GBN. So receiver side, similar action will be taken. You just see received packet not corrupt, and as the sequence number expected sequence number, extract it, deliver it, and make packet and send the acknowledgement. Then increase this variable expected next sequence number. For example, it has received. It is expecting sequence number 3 packet and it has received. Fine. Acknowledge it. Now you increase this one expected sequence number 4 and wait for that one. Otherwise, if it receives instead of 3, if it receives 4th, some other packet 4, then drop it. So GBN will not store, it will not buffer the packet, because you just think like it has received fourth packet. This sender has sent 3 and 4, something like this. It has received 4. And sender base is 1. And it has sent 3 and 4 also. It has received 4. And 3 is lost. You think like that. 3 is lost. Suppose if it stores 4 in this one, then here timeout will occur. You know, timeout will occur. And then timeout will occur. Then sender will resend all this packet. 1, 2, 3, 4. So storing 4 is here. It is meaningless. So it will not store 4. So that is the main advantage, it doesn't receive buffer, it won't doesn't require buffer, it will not store out of order packet. Clear? So out of order packet is discarded, no receiver buffering. So GBN action you can see here. So sender window size is 4, 0, 1, 2, 3. That means sender has sent packet 0, packet 1, packet 2, packet 3 without waiting for acknowledgement. Packet 2 is lost. Receiver has received packet 0 and it will send the acknowledgement. Receiver has received packet 1, it has sent acknowledgement. Receiver has received packet 3, but it has not received packet 2. That's why it will discard this one, packet 3, and it will resend the acknowledgement 1. Receiver has received packet 4, it will discard and resend the acknowledgement 1. Receiver has received packet 5, it will discard and resend the acknowledgement 1. If three times same acknowledgement comes here, then it is a direct indication for this go back and n. It need not to wait for the timeout. It can resend the packet starting from packet 3. So, but here what happens, we'll see in this scenario. In this scenario, what will happen, you will see. Somewhere here, packet timeout. Receiver receives acknowledgement 0, acknowledgement 1. But receiver receives some other acknowledgement, receiver receives acknowledgement 1, acknowledgement 2, etc. It has already received the acknowledgement, so it will ignore the acknowledgement. Now, there is one more concept is there. If it receives this acknowledgement three times, then it is directly understood that it should not wait for the timeout. That will I will tell you later. Now here, this time timeout occurs, what it will do? It will resend 2, 3, 4, 5. Because it has received packet 1, sorry, acknowledgement 1. That means when it receives acknowledgement 1, window will slide, right? Window will slide here. So now this is the base, right? So it will resend 2, 3, 4, 5. So that is the one case. The next one is selective repeat. So why we are using selective repeat? So you see here, which packet is lost? Packet 2 is lost, but it is sending packet 2, 3, 4, 5. So it is the waste of bandwidth or channel bandwidth. So how to avoid this one? Even though this is good, but this is a waste of channel bandwidth. Only packet 2 is lost. Here receiver can maintain some buffer and as soon as the packet 2 comes, it can reassemble the packet. But that is not happening in go back and n. So it will simply waste the channel bandwidth. So for this one is we have something called as a selective repeat. Only the packet which is lost, that will be sent. That is called as a selective repeat. So that we'll see in the next session. Thank you for watching.